Chris Blackheart making his way to the ringside area. This match against Roger Williams, MD. All right, there he is, everybody. Chris Blackheart making his way to the ring. Trusty briefcase in hand. Take on Roger Williams, MD. That's not him. I don't know if I've ever seen Roger Williams, MD.
Well, I have seen him a couple of times.
That's why you're my sidekick. You're so knowledgeable.
Another unorthodox wrestler. Certainly very energetic, tall, lanky guy. Likes to throw candy out to the kids at ringside.
Well, that always wins their support.
Oh my God, it's picking up.
All right, get up. You can clap. It's okay.
We had Dr. Heresy. We had Dr. X. Now we got Roger Williams, MD. Seems like
some of them we can treat the hand injuries that are going around today.
We can hope so. I guess the medical profession is not as lucrative as it once was. Everyone's just wanting to become a professional wrestler now.
Training's a lot cheaper.
It certainly is. Doctor going right for an arm wringer. I guess if he is the doctor, he's going to try to hurt that wrist, especially if he's seen any of these other matches today. Chris Blackheart not taking that too kindly. Oh, look at that. Another missed elbow drop. And another one. Doctor going back. Sorry, I won't call him doctor. He's not a doctor. He's an MD. Whatever difference that is. I think we need a good dentist on this show. Roger
Get
Williams.
Right on that.
Say what?
Get right on that.
All right.
Try to recruit one.
See what I can do. Chris Blackheart, former PLW world champion. Taking on Roger Williams here. Not faring too well. I'm sure Chris Blackheart would like to snag that PLW world title one more time in his career.
Well, I know these two have wrestled several other times before. Not on Power League shows, but they have wrestled before. And I don't know if maybe... most of the time, Roger Williams has got the short end of the stick on those matches. But it looks like he might have found something with his experience with Chris Blackheart that he's exploiting here.
Well, I think I know what he's exploiting. He's exploiting the fact that Chris Blackheart, for one of the first times I've ever seen him, doesn't have a man in his corner doing his dirty work for him. You always see someone in Chris Blackheart's corner. At Power Fest, he had Sir Lawrence. I didn't even think he knew Sir Lawrence. But he always finds a way to get someone in his corner helping him out. Blackheart taking advantage here.
Well, Chris Blackheart has a lot of money, a very influential individual. Not too surprising that he's got a lot of people
willing to help him out, like charity. Yeah, I get you.
I think you would do the same if asked, Amazing Jay.
I don't know.
I know I would.
There's a lot of people that try to get me down to ringside. If I had a nickel for every time. Sometimes it's not even people just asking me to be in their corner. It's usually just to be in the corner of their opponent. Not sure what that means, but it happens. Chris Blackheart taking a whip into the turnbuckle by Roger Williams, and then out with a bulldog. Doctor's going to town.
A little difficult to see emotion on the face of a masked wrestler, yeah, but you can see what the by putting the hands up to his head that he was a little frustrated with the slow count there.
I'm still trying to figure out what he's got on his mask. Is that a blue cross? That would be appropriate, wouldn't it?
A little sign language from Roger Williams to the referee there to let him know his displeasure with the count.
Chris Blackheart taking a fall right there. Roger Williams going for something. He's signaling for something, going up to the top rope with his Blue Cross mask. Chris Blackheart scouting the doctor pretty well. Big body slam off the top
rope. Chris Blackheart wasting no time to get him off the top rope there. He knew he didn't have long to catch him.
Blackheart going for an abdominal stretch right here. Slapping that on. It's the second time we've seen that tonight. Blackheart letting him down, turning into an arm bar right there.
So you got the submission off of the arm bar.
Roger Williams submitting to that arm bar.
Torqued that arm the wrong way. Might have dislocated a shoulder and elbow. A little odd to see a submission off of that maneuver. It's obvious that Roger Williams is hurt.
He couldn't seem to get out of that match quick enough. Maybe it had something to do with his neck. Maybe it was just twisting his neck the wrong way. He might have taken taking that big slam off the top rope kind of. You might be right. Maybe a dislocation. He might have hurt a vertebrae in there. Either way, a win for Chris Blackheart against the MD, Roger Williams.